Hey everyone, Melcadrien here, we're back with more Paradox Lost. As you can see, we are not at a save point, far from it. I did notice, however, one thing. The point where we got that scope, apparently, right next to it was a hidden block we just slide through, and turns out that there is a crystal up here. We couldn't get up here unless we had the flight ability, though. However, this is where the last person, yes, is at. So all we have to do is just save this one. And that's all 28. All the items. The entire map complete. Man. That really hits you in the spot, huh? The heart. It really hits you there. You know? It just says that you've completed everything. Now go fight the boss and see your well-deserved credits. Ah. That's quite a beautiful thing. I'm gonna stop the recording here, and we will be at the save point proper, near the boss room. So until then, I'll see you guys there in a moment. Okay, we're back. Now, moment of truth. We fight the boss. The final boss. And we're all up the wazoo. We are fully upgraded. So we can pretty much do just about anything we want to. At least, we can. Try to, anyways. That's one. Two. Three. Four and five. That takes care of this main area. Now I just map out the rest of the area. All right. These crystals do not want to give up. I wonder why they were fractured in the first place. Maybe it was because of that time traveler's meddling. I mean, we did see a fractured one the first time. So it would make sense if it was their meddling that caused the, well, time to go out of control. At least in this localized area, a sort of paradox. You know, why are there... Maybe it's just to protect the crystals. That's it. All destroyed. We got everything. 100%. Abby, you have restored time and saved my people. Now together, we can rebuild the future. Yay! We can rebuild the future. And hopefully the future won't be all messed up. And there's their health. Rusty's 30, Sean's 5, and Matt's 99. Wow. Basically, that is 100%. At least it should be. Man. The only reason why the credits are long is because it's a Kickstarter. And honestly, Kickstarter is a good way for, you know, people to get their work out. I mean, thanks to Kickstarter, a lot of good games have been released without the need of a publisher. Basically, they removed the need for a publisher and went directly to us. We became their publisher, and they have to uphold it, because it's sort of a trust thing. They trust us to give them money to make their game, so that way they can give it to us so we can play it and have fun. And they have to sell that concept to us, or else we won't back them. Now the only problem with that is the fact that sometimes people will just... they will just abuse it. I'm not too happy about that, but people do that. Maybe it's because they believe that this should happen, but they just believe it should happen, even if they don't believe it. If the game doesn't succeed the Kickstarter, there are a few problems with that. One, people don't notice it enough. Two, people don't seem to understand the concept. Three, people are aren't interested in the concept. And four, the concept sucks. Now, I've seen a lot of a few Kickstarters, which were just basically RPG Maker stuff with just, you know, RPG Maker graphics, RPG Maker story, gameplay. That's not what I want to see. What I want to see is an interesting concept. Granted, if you look at my YouTube, there is a few RPG Maker games. Well, basically, what was it? Corpse Spirit? No. Grave Spirit. As well as You Are Not the Hero. The difference between those two is the fact that I see them and I see a lot of a good concept, something that sells me on it. That and it doesn't really feel like an RPG Maker game. It feels like they've taken the whole RPG Maker thing and just reworked the system so that it would work for them. So that way it doesn't exactly feel like an RPG Maker game, but in other ways it is. And that's the good thing, it's not, and yet it is. So it basically makes you think it's not. It's very confusing, yes, but part of the matter is that it's not an RPG Maker game anymore. It's something new, it's something different, it's not just a game where you play an RPG, it's something else. And that's what I liked about those concepts. That's what I believe about Kickstarters and, well, Indiegogo. If you manage to sell the concept, people will see it. That and you need to plug it in from time to time because not a whole lot of people will see it. That's another problem. If people don't see it, then the problem isn't exactly you. It's the lack of presence the Kickstarter has. If you don't give it any presence, you know, like you don't work with people to give it this sort of presence, then it's not exactly gonna work. Now, it may also be a good and a bad thing in a way, because when a game reaches a funding goal, that means they're most likely able to get the game out at that right time. If it is overfunded, you know what will happen? The game will take longer to develop, which is, for example, the Double Fine Adventure, Broken Age, that's a result of overfunding, because they were given a huge budget to work with, so they basically had a lot to work with, and they had to enlarge the scale of it because of it. And I'm glad that it did take a while for them to enlarge the scale of it. We had thought that it was going to be some neat game, whereas it was just going to be just a regular Flash game. And now it's this legitimate game with actual graphics, voice actors, all that stuff. But yeah, kickstarting games is a double-bladed thing, double-edged thing. Sometimes it will benefit not only you, but the developers as well. Also, it can also hurt both you and the developer, or just you and, well, not the developer, depending on what may happen. But that's the end of Paradox Lost. Tune in next time, guys, when I play another game. So until then, this is Melcadrien. I'm signing off. Have a great day, guys, and happy gaming.